Hi guys! Today we are going to be making street style Thatte Idli. This is absolutely delicious. It tastes best when it is hot, smeared with lots of butter or ghee and has some podi on it. So let's begin. First I'm taking some Sona Masori Rice, some urad dal, some poha and sabudana. I'm also adding a little bit of methi seeds. You need to soak it for at least 6 hours. After 6 hours, grind the methi plus the urad dal first into an absolutely smooth paste. Transfer this into a bowl. You have to make sure that the urad dal has been ground very finely. Now, in another jar, grind the soaked rice along with the poha, the sabudana, basically all the other balance ingredients all together. Now, the texture of the rice can be as desired. If you like it to be slightly grainy, you can leave it grainy or make it super smooth. This time, I'm just leaving the texture slightly grainy. I personally feel that a grainy texture gives a better idli texture. So now, I'm going to be mixing the urad dal mixture with the rice mixture. You can see that my mixture is neither too thick nor is it too thin. If you're going to make it very thin, your idlis are not going to come out very well, and if it's going to be very thick, it will not ferment well. Now, cover this mixture and set it aside for at least 12 hours. Best is to leave it overnight. After 12 hours, you will see that the mixture has risen. To this, add some salt. You can see it is nice and bubbly and frothy. After adding the salt, mix it very gently. Do not overmix it. Now the batter is ready to make soft and fluffy idlis. I am making Thatte Idli, that is why I am making this in a plate. I have put a banana leaf, smear some oil. Be very, very gentle with the oil. You don't have to put too much oil. Put 3 to 4 spoons of batter onto a plate. And before all this, you have to make sure that your steaming pot is absolutely bubbly. Put it in, cover it and cook it on high flame for 10 to 12 minutes. After 10 to 12 minutes, the idli is ready. It is hot and steamy. Put some ghee on top, sprinkle some podi and you're good to go. This is one of my most favorite breakfast recipes. This idli tastes best when it is served fresh. It is very spongy, it is light, it's healthy, perfect for a nice Sunday breakfast. So I hope you guys enjoyed watching this recipe too and will make this very soon. Whenever you guys make this recipe, please don't forget to tag me. If you have not subscribed to my YouTube channel, please do subscribe to it. Like this video and do leave a comment. I'll see you guys with more such recipes very, very soon. Till then, take care and bye-bye.